Hello, welcome to another video with me, Christian Rauchenwald. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can add Google Tag Manager to your funnels in ClickFunnels. And I'm going to show you two different ways so you can choose which one is actually easier for you and which one you prefer. To get started, you need to log into your Google Tag Manager account and there simply click on the Google Tag Manager ID and you will see the scripts that you have to add to your funnels. So I'm simply going to copy the first script here and head to our ClickFunnels account. There, go to the funnels page, select the funnel where you want to use Google Tag Manager in, and head to the settings section to add the required tracking code. Now the first piece of code goes into the header tracking code, so I'm going to expand that a little bit and paste it here. And additionally, you'll also need the second piece of code, which you are supposed to add in the body tracking code section here. Now, once that's done, all you have to do is scroll down and click save and update script, and it will add Google Tag Manager to your funnels. Now, before I show you the second method that you can use to add Google Tag Manager to your funnels, I want to point out a few things here. First of all, if you ever need support from ClickFunnels, they are usually going to tell you to remove any kind of custom code from your funnels, which means in many cases, if you run into issues whatsoever, you will have to remove that code from here and later add it again. And additionally, if you want to use the same Google Tag Manager in multiple funnels at once, you will have to add the code separately to each of those funnels. Now, the second method of adding Google Tag Manager to your funnels hosted at ClickFunnels is by using CF Power Scripts, which in my opinion is the easier way, and I'm going to show you right now how it works and why it is the better solution. So first things first, you will need your free CF Power Scripts account, and once you're logged in, you simply go to Power Scripts and you either add the Google Tag Manager to all your funnels at once, or you simply select the funnel where you want to add it to. Once you're at the scope, so either on the global scope or on the funnel level or even on a funnel step or funnel page specifically, simply click on Add New, look for Google Tag Manager, and as you see, all we need is the Tag Manager ID. So we go back to our Google Tag Manager account, and where previously we had to copy both codes, now we only need the Google Tag Manager ID, which is the string that you can see up here, starting with GTM minus and then a random letters and numbers combination. Now, once we paste that Google Tag Manager ID here and click on Add Script, we've successfully added it to this specific funnel, or if we would have added it on the global scope before, to all funnels at once. Now, so far, there is no huge difference other than that you don't have to deal with copying custom code and you only need the Google Tag Manager ID compared to copying two pieces of code. However, the real difference comes in when you need support from ClickFunnels and they tell you to remove your custom code, because within CF Power Scripts, you can simply click on Edit to open the settings of the Power Script and disable the Power Script. In that case, Google Tag Manager or any other Power Script that you disable in this fashion will not be active in your live funnel step. It will still work in your preview funnel step, which can also be used, for example, when you're working on custom code and you already have traffic on your live page, so you don't risk breaking your funnel while people try to check out, and you can in peace finish your custom code or whatever integration you're working on, and only once you're sure it's working, activate it again. And again, as mentioned, when you're in communications with ClickFunnels support because you're running to some issue and they ask you to disable custom code, you can simply disable the scripts here and they will not be executed on the live funnel step, so ClickFunnels support can easily test your funnels without the need of deleting all your custom codes and adding them later again. That's it. That's how easy you can add Google Tag Manager to your funnels. As always, if you took anything positive away from this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more ClickFunnels tutorials, make sure to hit that subscribe button and also enable the bell icon so you get notified when we publish new videos. Thanks for watching and see you in one of our other videos. Till then, bye-bye.